Another day. Trying to get the batteries and charge controller in. I found a spot for the charge controller. Back in there. But that requires getting this panel out, which has been really, really tough. It was stapled, it had a couple pocket screws, and now the wires, these wires are in the way to get it out. So I have to pull my wires back through, which is my least favorite thing to do. And then hopefully be able to get this out, get the charge controller mounted in there, out of sight, out of mind. I feel good about that decision. Well, it's taken us 2 hours to get this panel knocked out, and it wasn't graceful. Oh, that's why. Another screw in there. Yeah, that makes it hard. Cool. Now I can work around it. Hopefully I can get it out of here. Yeah. Well, no wonder. Thought I'd got that one out. Oops. Well, now it's out. The hammer helped me get that out. Could have been worse. But now I've got room for my charge controller in there. It's almost as exciting as finding like a $100 bill in your wallet when you find extra space in your trailer that's not used or accessible. I've been going to town taking this apart. I'm not sure why Airstream puts the big bump out in there. It eats up a lot of that open space in there. Maybe it looks cool, but the counter space back here isn't super useful. I'd rather have it back with the square table, with a square sink, and just cut the front off. We're pulling this out. This is a false cabinet in there. There's nothing in there normally, so that's where the so that's where the charge controller is going to go. But if we were to cut that front plate off, we would still have all this for storage. So I don't really understand the need to bump it out. But that's okay. That just means when we rebuild this one day and chop that off and put a new counter in, we'll have plenty of storage just like we did before that. All right, this is feeling good. I'm trying to leave at least one screw still intact from the factory on here. We're gonna put the charge controller in there. We got a nice room to route the wires. Everything's looking good there. This is taking way too long, but I'm happy with how it turned out. This is my mount for the charge controller. Got some pocket hole screws in there. It's all gonna go in there. Well, Corbin's back tonight to give us some help. We are getting the batteries disconnected on the tongue, which involves disconnecting the leads going up there, which involves taking out the whole corner piece of furniture. They've hidden it with a panel that's not easily accessible. Boy, the lengths Corbin will go to help us out. This is what's needed to access the wiring up there. This just gives me hope, though, for the day that we put the couch up front and get rid of the dinette and put a desk over here. It's coming. We just want to hit the road more than we want to put that in right now. This is the part I've been dreading this whole time. I'm modifying the storage cabinet over here to fit the batteries. And when I cut my hole over here, I was using a jigsaw. But the jigsaw is just too big to fit in these tight little spots. So now I'm totally using the wrong tool for the job, but it's actually leaving a really clean edge. I'm using my angle grinder with a flap disc. And it's getting really clean edges, but it makes a lot of smoke and gotta run the fans and exhaust it all out. But it's a really clean cut. Okay, we cut this out. I should be able to fit all five batteries in here. I need to build the brace to handle the weight that I just took out from that. So that's next. Alright, let me show you why I did all that. We got five of these, and they need to all be able to fit through here. Ooh, that's tight. It does fit though. Barely. I think that's what we were going for. Okay, now I need to build my support roof thing to support this center column better. Things are looking good. Teresa's using her skinny fingers to get a little bolt on there. We got three of the five batteries in there. Looks like it was meant to be in there. It's 1:30. We're calling it a night.